Steve Pilcher hails from Burlington, Ontario, but his day job with Pixar Animation keeps him very busy in California, and he got up extra early this morning to talk about his Oscar-winning film, Soul. Just picked up two Oscars, Best Animated Feature and Best Original Score. Congratulations, another Academy Award winner that you were, that you had a huge part in.
Thanks, Bob.
That's it? Two Oscars? Thanks, Bob.
I don't know what else to say. Well, I don't know.
That was years of work.
Yeah, it's about 3 or 4 years of work. Yeah, each time we do them. Last time I worked on Brave, that was 7 years of work. So then
it's
I did
amazing.
Dory and Green, and Dory was like 4 years, and this one's like, the production on this film was only 2 years. So it's about 3.5 years in development, like, and then we just got the green light, and we only had 2 years. So it was pretty intense.
That's a fast track. I remember last time you were in our studio, you were here for Brave, and I asked you what you're working on next, and you said this movie, Finding Dory. And yeah, it's years in the process. Tell us, for those who haven't seen it yet on Disney Plus, tell us the storyline of Soul, which is, people are just, the reviews are amazing, and of course, the aforementioned Oscars.
Well, that's it's a little tricky for me to nutshell that thing, but basically a jazz musician who is pursuing his passion at the expense of maybe other things and simple things in life. And he needs to rediscover those. And there's all kinds of comedy and deeper, profound kind of things. So it takes animation in a little different way, a little more sophisticated way, which I really enjoyed.
Yeah,
it's a thinking film.
Yeah, these little souls are in the great before. As a production designer, how did you create, what kind of thought went into creating this world?
First thing you have to do is separate the two worlds. There's the real world, and then there's the great before, the soul world, which we apparently can't see. So you have to contrast everything. That's the best way I can describe it. So everything that is earthly, you do the opposite with color, with design, just all the philosophical thinking that you can think of. And we have lots of discussions like that. But keeping it entertaining.
Right, which you guys do incredibly. As a production designer, tell us about your role and how you work with the director and the writers.
Well, my role is I work with a team of about 10 artists, and that rotates throughout the production. I also supervise the other departments, the lighting department and, the sets department, and to build all these things. So I work really close with the director. And we have to be in perfect sync, basically, to make sure that I'm interpreting and expressing what's needed in the film visually. So there's a lot of collaboration and discussion, and we do that right across the board with everybody.
Yeah.
It's a very collaborative art form, yeah.
Now there's another Burlington.
So I create designs, artwork, lighting keys, paintings, all kinds of things to steer it.
Wow. So there's another Burlington native, Trevor Jimenez, who was also involved with Soul, and another GTA resident. Did you cross paths or separate departments?
No, we crossed paths a lot. Trevor's a good friend. He grew up in Toronto, and he did another short film, which was Oscar nominated, called Weekends. But anyway, Trevor he was working in story, and I think he directed one of our sequences, and he came up with some amazing inventive ideas that we talk directly, his department, our department. The more you can do, the more you can collaborate, the better result you get.
Yeah, now you're coming to us from, this isn't a normal office or living room, or you're in a very creative space at home. So you've had no problems working remotely for Pixar?
Yeah, I was working, when I finished Soul, it was right at the beginning of the pandemic. Right at the end, like at the end of my part on the film, which is the last couple of months, and they had to finish the rest at home that week, bringing all their computers home. So I was at home, I was pretty much done at that point. But now I'm working remotely. I've been working a year on another film.
Yeah, what are you working on?
I'm working on, I can't say the title of it, but I'm working with a Netflix film, which is with Cuckoo Studios, which are some former Pixar employees, which created their own small studio. So I'm kind of helping them out and enjoying myself doing that too.
Well, that's a good excuse for you to come back on Morning Live and talk about it. By the way, before we let you go, the Steve Pilcher story started at CHCH. You had a summer job in our promo department. Your dad worked here, and you actually created all the artwork for shows like Hilarious House of Frankenstein and the Leafs and Flip Wilson? The Flip Wilson show you did?
Flip Wilson and Burt Bacharach, and there's a bunch of them. I almost got to meet Vincent Price because I was doing caricatures, the characters, and he was in that day, but we missed. He wanted to meet me, and I missed him. And of course, now I can't meet him. He's passed away. But that was a lot of fun. I have very fond memories of CH and working with you guys were great to work with. I have just really fond memories. I was like 15 or 16.
So what you're saying is, it all started at CHCH. So next time you're at the Oscars, you'll mention us, right?
I will do that if I can ever get up on that stage.
You should be. Continued success. Steve Pilcher.
Thanks, Bob.